In this video, I'm going to find the domain of the real valid function f, which is equals to 1 divided by the square root of 3 minus x. And for the second question, given the functions f of x, which is equals to 4x plus 1, and g of x, which is equals to 2x squared plus 5x, I'm going to find the composition of g and f. So looking at the first function there, the f, which is equals to 1 divided by square root of 3 minus x. By definition, the domain of a function is the set of values for which the function is defined. So to find these values for which the function is defined, we look at this fraction here. For that fraction there, its denominator must not be equal to 0. So it is not equal to 0 if the 3 minus x there is not equal to 0. So if 3 minus x is not equal to 0, we'll be having x is not equal to 3. So if x is not equal to 3, we'll be having that that function there would be defined. But we also need to look at what is under the square root sign there, the square root of 3 minus x. We are looking at a real valid function. And for a real valid function, what is under the square root there should be greater than 0. So in this case, we should be having that 3 minus x must be greater than 0. So behaving that x is less than 3. So in this case, the set of values for which x is defined is the set of real numbers such that x is less than 3. So behaving that the domain of that function is the set of values where we have x being a real number such that x is less than 3. I will now move on to the next question there, finding the composition of those two functions, g and f. By definition, the composition of g and f is equals to g of f of x. So I can go on and write g of f of x. But we have our f of x there, it's 4x plus 1. So where we are having f of x in this equation, I replace with the 4x plus 1. So we would have g of 4x plus 1. But we have our g of x there, which is equals to 2x squared plus 5x. So that's the g of x there. What we are saying there, we replace wherever we are having this x, we replace with the 4x plus 1. So that we would have 2 multiplied by 4x plus 1 squared plus 5 multiplied by 4x plus 1. And this part here can be simplified to 32x squared plus 36x plus 7. So that's the composition of g and f.